watching continuing local news coverage from Colorado's biggest news team. Now, Fox 31 Morning News at 6.
Right now, Denver's weather heating up, and we are looking ahead to the weekend and Colorado's next storm system.
All aboard! RTD making commutes a little easier when you can start bringing your e-bike along with you.
Plus, a problem solver's health alert and a new warning for women who vape.
And did you know pumpkin spice foods cost a whole lot more than the regular version? How much more you're paying to be super basic. 6 o'clock.
Totally basic.
Good to have you. Oh, this thing? Oh, yeah, this is new, too.
Yeah, just a little something.
In the new studio to start this Thursday morning. Not bad, and great to have you guys with us. I'm Kirk Yonke.
I'm Ashley Ryan. Kylie, we're loving the upgrade.
We are. I mean, it's so nice and bright, so much space to move around.
Spread your wings and fly,
exactly,
Kylie.
Hey, I want to talk a little bit about the changing of the sunrise and sunset time, because as of today, we officially have less than 11 hours of daylight. So it feels like days are getting shorter so quickly. Sunrise not until 7:15, so we have an hour and 15 minutes to go, probably about 45 minutes from seeing some daylight here, but 7:13 that sun goes down. Live look from your Backus and Schenker camera. Temps right now in the mid to upper 40s. Good visibility, just a touch of a breeze. We're at 36 in Fort Morgan, Georgetown this morning at 40 degrees, Edwards at 25, here in Denver, 47. Hour by hour today brings you into the 70s. A nice warm day ahead, reaching a near 80 degrees, so well above average for this time of year. But I do have my first, what I think will be Denver's first freeze in the forecast. We'll talk about when in just a few.
And hey, we are tracking a time saver traffic alert this morning. This is I-270 in the westbound direction. Sky Fox live over the scene right now. It looks like four cars involved in this crash. They have the westbound direction completely shut down. You can see that fire truck right there, and unfortunately an ambulance on scene. It looks like there could be some serious injuries involved in this crash. So 270, not a shortcut right now. Just take I-70 to I-25, as we're seeing some major issues in the westbound direction of I-270. Also have that issue I-25 northbound as you get onto I-70 in that eastbound direction. So if you're heading out to the airport this morning, a big heads up as you head out the door. Look at that. Some major delays northbound I-25 onto eastbound I-70. So big heads up for those folks that are heading out to DIA this morning, guys.
All right. Thank you, Drew. This morning, giving renters more rights with a bit of a controversial move this morning.
Well, Denver voters will be able to decide whether landlords should pay for eviction defenses. So how would it work? Let's get right to Fox 31's Carly Moore on it live this morning. And we know it was a big issue throughout the pandemic as evictions were put on pause.
Good morning, Kirk. Ashley, yeah, this is a citizen-driven proposal, and it's called No Eviction Without Representation. And basically, this would tax landlords every year to fund eviction defenses for people who do get evicted. So here's how it would work. Here's what you need to know. The ballot language says it would tax landlords $75 a year for each property. These funds go to help pay for every tenant to have free legal representation during an eviction case. Now, the Department of Housing Stability said almost 9,000 evictions take place in Denver every year. The proponents of the issue say 90% of the time corporate landlords have legal representation, while renters only have legal counsel 1% of the time. They also say that eviction has a ripple effect and can lead to homelessness. So here, let's hear from both sides.
I mean, the way that it would work is it would give people the same sort of right to an attorney that they would already have in a criminal case, right? And it would inform them right at the beginning of the process that they have that right and give them access to a free attorney.
If we focus on upstream of an eviction, then we can keep more people in their homes because we're actually trying to ward off an eviction at that point. I think the funds could be better utilized for programs that actually help way before an eviction happens. And those programs exist.
Now, proponents say this will prevent unjust evictions and help the affordable housing crisis. Now, arguments by the opponents say that $75 tax will cause landlords to increase rent to cover that, and that will make housing even more unaffordable. Additionally, they say the Common Sense Institute ran the numbers and says that the program is costly and will actually take more money to implement than it would raise. Now, right now, there is currently a program in the city of Denver to fund lawyers for people who are evicted For lower income families, this new proposal does not have an income limit. Live in Denver this morning, Carly Moore, Fox 31.
Interesting proposal here. We'll have to see which way that goes. Thank you, Carly.
Happening this morning, the 17-year-old suspect in a 14-year-old's death expected to make his first court appearance. Diego Lopez being charged as an adult in this case. He's accused of shooting, stabbing, and beating Josea's Jojo Aragon on August 8th. Police say they went to school together and had been talking about buying a gun. Diego's mom also expected to attend the hearing this morning and will reportedly be making a statement on how she says the district attorney has mischaracterized her son.
All right, RTD riders, how much are you willing to pay for your RTD tickets? Well, you'll get a chance to voice your opinion on that today.
Let's get right to you, Fox 31's Kristen Chapman on it live this morning. And I think the frustration is that everybody is already paying more for everything else.
Good morning. That is the frustration. I mean, inflation is impacting so many people right now. So this poses an important question. Are RTD prices too expensive? So that's why RTD will host a virtual meeting tonight so that people can air their concerns and their grievances about what's going on about ticket fares. So this comes after many people around Colorado were stating that the prices are too expensive and they're confusing. So the CEO of RTD, Deborah Johnson, and the general manager, she had to say, quote, RTD is creating a new fare structure that will be simpler to understand, more affordable, and more equitable without reducing current service levels. So suggestions from the public during the last meeting, that included things like reduced group fares, free youth passes, half fare days for larger events, service reliability, and potentially creating 24 or 30-hour day passes. This comes as RTD has made changes to its security, naming a new police chief, Dr. Joel Fitzgerald, in August. Also, just yesterday, announcing it will allow riders to travel with e-bikes. At the beginning of the month, more than 4,000 people have redeemed Colorado's e-bike voucher. So the RTD meeting tonight will be held virtually at 6 p.m. You do need to pre-register to be a part of it. We have a link on our website to do so. They will hold another meeting in about a week from now. That will happen on October 27th. Reporting live from Denver, I'm Kristen Chapman, Fox 31 News.
All right, Kristen, definitely something we'll be keeping a close eye on there as well. Thank you. 6:07 right now.
New developments from North Gun Police after two teens were shot and killed in the backyard of a home earlier this month. Officials say no arrests or charges will be filed. This after a 15 and 16-year-old reportedly broke a fence to get into a yard and tried to get into sort of a garage-like structure that was attached to the home. Police say one of the boys had a semi-automatic pistol, the other a machete. When they encountered the man who lives there, we're told that man exchanged gunfire with one of the boys. Officials say the man was targeted with multiple gunshots but was not injured.
A great political moment involving the former vice president. This was great because of how revealing yet candid it was.
Right, what he was alluding to, right, which was pretty obvious. A lot of people talking about this morning. Former Vice President Mike Pence at the event was asked, would he vote for Trump in 2024? Let's get over to Drew on it with the video everyone is talking about.
Yeah, looking ahead to the presidential race of 2024, former Vice President Mike Pence continues to distance himself from the former president as speculation grows that he will soon take on his old boss as candidate for president. So take a look at what he said last night when asked if he would vote for the former president if you were to win the nomination.
Well, there might be somebody else I'd prefer more.
Yeah, Pence also condemned the violence on January 6th and said that Americans from all backgrounds have told him that they support his certifying of the election on that day. Now, Pence did bypass several questions regarding him, the rift between him and former President Trump, Kirk. And actually, this was last night, an event that was hosted by Conservative Young America's Foundation at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. And again, still no official announcement from Pence that he would run for president, but you can almost take that as an unofficial announcement, right?
I mean, it's fairly obvious what he was saying there, don't you think?
I think so.
But, and I think a lot of people have speculated that, but he has not really said, I'm going to run until sort of that.
I guess we're still a little over 2 years out. So
that's true. Thank you, Drew.
Yep.
A problem solver's health alert this morning. E-cigarettes could do long-term damage to children if their moms vape while pregnant. A new study out of Ohio State University shows the long-term effects of vaping while pregnant. The CDC says 7% of pregnant women in the U.S. still vape despite warnings against it. The study shows pregnant women who use e-cigs may predispose their children to develop adult lung diseases like asthma or COPD, even if the vape does not contain nicotine.
All right, the Denver Nuggets have started their season. Their first game was in Salt Lake City. Nikola Jokic starting his quest for his third consecutive MVP title last night. The game did not go Denver's way, unfortunately. Denver lost to the Utah Jazz by 21 points. The good news is Michael Porter Jr., Jamal Murray, both healthy, returning to the lineup, so pretty much full strength. The home opener at Ball Arena in Denver, by the way, is Saturday against the Oklahoma City Thunder.
How fun!
Super fun. Good to see basketball back in action.
Yeah.
A lot of expectations for the Nuggets.
Hopefully a great season ahead.
I miss it. Did you say they won or they lost?
They lost.
They lost first game, but that's okay.
That's okay.
Work out the kinks.
A lot of games in basketball.
Definitely a lot. Hey, guys, we've got some big changes headed our way. But, for really today, we're going to be above average in the next several days before... Look at this drop in temperatures that's coming. We'll talk more about this with my 7-day in just a few, but let's get you ready to head out the door this morning. Taking the kiddo out to the bus stop, it is going to be in the low 40s, so definitely want that light jacket. And then as we're getting into this afternoon, upper 70s, mild and, breezy. Here we go. Live look from your back as a Janker camera. Mid to upper 40s so far this morning. We are seeing those temps right around 50 in Broomfield, 35 in Lakewood, and 45 degrees in Foxfield. So for today, it's going to be in the upper 70s, a really warm day ahead. But changes are coming, guys. I've got a storm system moving in this weekend. Going to cause a big impact for our high country. We'll talk more about it in just a few.
Meantime, it feels like the end of August.
I know.
Good gravy. Thank you, Kylie. Coming up, a dangerous intersection has neighbors turning to the Fox 31 problem solvers. The answers we are getting from CDOT and the city next.
Plus, astronauts can now enjoy a taste of luxury while floating through the cosmos.
And guys, another look from SkyFox at this time saver traffic alert that we're tracking right now. You see they still have the interstate completely shut down in the westbound direction of I-270 at York. We did see an ambulance come by. It looks like four cars involved in this crash. 270 is backed up for the entirety of that interstate, 270. So just take I-70 to I-25 for now. We'll keep you posted on this crash in the westbound direction of 270 at York.
Fox 31 News.
Welcome back, guys. 6:15.
Welcome to my new area.
This is a new pod. Do you like this?
I love this.
It's kind of shiny.
Computer. It's shiny. We've got a big old screen in the back. I bought a house last year, and all I want to do is host people over. So I'm so glad you guys came over to my studio. Well,
it's good to be here. Thanks for having us, Kylie.
Anytime. Come on over. But now I need you guys to leave so that I can talk about the forecast because we do have a lot that's going on here over the next couple of days. So here's a look at what I'm watching. We've got more warm days on the way. I wish everyone could have seen the way that we all just scattered away from the camera. We've got weekend showers on the way and mountain snow, potentially some really good snow. Right now from your back of the Janker camera, temps are in the mid to upper 40s. Just a touch of a breeze, good visibility out there. 30 degrees in Greeley, 40 in Lyman, and we are below freezing through most of your high country. Nothing on radar. You know what that means. You got a lot of sunshine for your wind. Nope. Thursday. Temperatures today reaching into the upper 70s for a little bit later on today. We're near 80 for most of the Front Range Eastern Plains, low 80s down in southeastern Colorado, 60s and 70s through your high country. As far as your wind goes, just about 5-10 miles per hour. Not a lot going on. Let's talk about this weekend, though. You've probably heard people talking about it. We've got a storm system on the way. And granted, it's Thursday. We're talking about Sunday. We're still a few days out. But so far, the forecast has been on track for this storm system to arrive in the mountains Sunday morning, snowing throughout the day Sunday, bringing rain to the Front Range. There is a slight chance that we could see a few snowflakes here in the metro area come Sunday night into early Monday morning. Not super likely. This is really looking to be a bigger impact storm system for our high country. So 3 to 6, even up to 10 inches in a few spots. We'll be watching it for you. We love to see that. And of course, the Front Range, not expected to see a lot of action, but we're going to be watching this closely for you. Make sure you've got that Pinpoint Weather app downloaded so you are good to go as we fine tune that forecast as we get a little closer. Sunday's going to be windy in the mid 60s, low 50s come Monday. And guys, early heads up, early next week, I think we're going to see our first freeze in Denver. Yeah. So we've already had it throughout a good chunk of the Front Range. Mountains, obviously, well below freezing, but certainly something to keep in mind. Sprinklers, any sensitive vegetation.
Well, we're way overdue.
We are. October 7th is the average date of that first freeze.
You guys want a tour? You want a little tour?
Show everybody what's going on here.
Come with me. I'll show you around. Because the new studio here is all about new ways, better ways to tell you about news and weather. You saw Kylie's giant weather wall. This is all about telling you guys what's going on. She's got a couple more monitors. And especially when severe weather hits, winter weather hits, we have the tools, the resources to kind of show you how all that's developing. And if we move a little bit further down in here into the studio, we've got a whole another area over here. More cool screens and new ways that we're going to be able to kind of storytell, if you will, and explain to you what's happening here in Colorado as you guys wake up with us. Obviously, kind of home base, if you will. I like to call it the breakfast table in the morning. Hi! High five.
Cheers.
This is our little main area here, the breakfast table. You know, it's the same deal. We're still bringing you the same news. It's just kind of a new way of doing it. Back here, hi, Kylie. Hi, Drew.
Hi.
Kylie and Drew are back there. I'm not going to take you back there.
No, come back here. You can go back.
Okay, let's go back. Come on, real quick. We'll go in. Elliot, follow me. This is where Kylie is. Look at all the monitors they have. This is for tracking weather, tracking big news, tracking big traffic situations. I know there's no fancy lighting back here, but I think it's cool.
It's so cool to see.
I wanted to show you what's going on back there as we're moving back here into the main studio. So that's just a little kind of inside look into what we're doing here, why you know our company spent the money to develop all of these new tools. Again, same newscast. We're still waking up with you guys, having breakfast with you.
Well, and show the directors.
There's no light over there, Tom.
Not directors, but robotics. Teleprompter. There they are.
Screaming for attention back there. So that's Tom. He's actually running all the robotic cameras right now. We've got our teleprompter operator back there. I can't even see you guys. I know.
And then that doesn't even count the control room, which is where they do the audio.
The belly of the beast back there.
Yeah.
Anyhow.
Directing.
A little inside look for you this morning. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. 619 right now.
All right. Astronauts can now enjoy, this is pretty cool, a taste of luxury while they're floating through the cosmos, but I think that's cool enough.
It's super cool. Yeah. The French champagne manufacturer GH Mumm has developed a futuristic champagne bottle that dispenses small spheres of bubbly, which astronauts can then sip as they float in zero
Look
gravity.
At that.
It's really cool. The liquid is stored in the upper portion of the half glass bottle, emerges as a foam while natural gas forces it out. This is the first champagne designed specifically to be enjoyed while floating around in space.
Well, take a look at this. Scientists found the remains of a small community of Neanderthals believed to have lived around 54,000 years ago. Their well-preserved skeletal bones allowed researchers...
That's the whole Neanderthal there.
Well, researchers were able to extract DNA samples and paint a fascinating picture of the origin of human families. About 20 different cavemen and women were found, and scientists say men usually stayed close to the family, while women were more likely to travel outside of the clan to find mates. Interesting. A long time ago, 54,000 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
All right, time now, 620. Coming up, a Colorado Rockies outfielder reminding men to check for testicular cancer. His big new campaign when we come back.
And brand new data shows how many hours you have to work to afford a place in Denver. And Drew's watching Time Saver Traffic Alert. Drew, what part of town is this?
Yeah, this is on the west side, or east side of town, I should say, but the westbound direction of I-270, guys. The good news is they now have one lane of traffic open, but I'm looking at the map here. The entirety of 270 in that westbound direction, the entire interstate is backed up right now. They had it blocked off all lanes of traffic in that westbound direction just a moment ago. It looks like four cars involved in this crash there. But 270, not a shortcut this morning, guys. Just take I-70 to get to I-25. But again, from Sky Fox, now one lane of traffic is open back up. We'll keep you posted on this Time Saver Traffic Alert. Stay with us.
And right now, live look from our fine airport parking cam out at DIA, obviously waiting for the sun to rise. This beautiful start to our morning.
You're watching Fox 31, Colorado's most watched morning news. Live from Denver, this is Fox 31 News.
You know, I was just thinking, I wish there were more advertisements in my life.
Yeah, I think that's what everyone wants.
New this morning, Uber launching a new advertising division. Get ready.
All right, so customers will soon see ads pop up on their Uber apps as they wait for their rides or for their deliveries. Uber thinks they can reach $1 billion in ad revenue by 2024. The ads aren't going to start everywhere at once. No word yet, though, exactly on when the company will roll that out and exactly where.
Do we get a discount on our Uber rate?
Right. If I watch the app, will you drop 50 cents? I'll just sit there and watch ads. till it's free.
Seems fair.
Yeah. Fans of Taco Bell needing a jolt of fast food energy can also fast charge their electric vehicles.
Taco Bell near San Francisco has turned some of its parking lot into an electric vehicle charging area, installing 6 ChargeNet stations. They're solar powered and can give 100 miles of range in about 20 minutes, they say, for $20. Another 120 Taco Bells in California owned by Diversified Restaurant Group will also be adding the stations and will receive a revenue percentage from ChargeNet. If you want to enjoy all things pumpkin spice this season, and so many people do, prepare to pay for it.
Well, according to a report by finance website Magnify Money, pumpkin spice items overall are 14% more expensive than other varieties. And some pumpkin spice foods cost up to 160% more than regular versions. The data shows retailers typically charge an informal pumpkin spice tax, they won't admit it, for all the fall flavored groceries and items. And I know a lot of the end caps, the
it's all pumpkin spice right now. I just wish they itemized that. Pumpkin spice tax, $2.
Yeah, just tell me exactly
how much more you're paying.
You know what? I'll just go with the regular.
A huge criminal ring busted, blamed for stolen identities, stolen documents, stolen cars. How investigators cracked this case, plus the way you can protect your identity from being stolen.
Beautiful pictures coming in. I love this one. I feel like we're just holding on to fall. It's so beautiful. Jeff shared this picture on the Approachable Outdoors Facebook group, which, by the way, if you love fall pictures, join the group. Anyone's welcome to. You can post pictures there. Oh, rooster, making my morning. If you've got a weather picture that you want to share, send it my way. Kylie.Burst@KDVR.com is the place to send them.
FOX 31, Colorado's most watched morning news. Live from Denver, this is FOX 31 News at 6:30.
Oh, beautiful start to your morning. We've got a nice warm couple of days, but I'm watching for some big changes this weekend.
Alleged rideshare sex assaults, a man picking up women, kidnapping and attacking them. What police want you to know.
Bill.
What?
Strange things are afoot at the Circle K.
Just like Bill and Ted said, there are, in fact, some strange things afoot at Circle K's in Florida.
Oh.
We'll break that down.
Good morning. Hope your Thursday morning is off to a great start. I'm Ashley Ryan.
And I'm Kirk Yonke. Oh, obviously, a new digs here, new studio, and good to have you guys hanging out with us, finally able to reveal what we've been working on for months now. And you've been busy, Drew, some road issues out there?
Yeah, there's a big time saver traffic alert. We're going to get to that in just a moment. But Kylie wants to show off her brand new weather wall over there.
I do love it, especially because, I mean, the weather is just so gorgeous to talk about, too. I've got changes coming. We're going to break those down for you in just a few. But first, we've got a live look from your Backus and Schenker camera this morning. Look at that. What a beauty. We're still about 45 minutes away from official sunrise. But I love when we start to get that first look at daylight. I feel like the day starts to wake up a little bit. Mid to upper 40s so far this morning, 45 degrees in Boulder, 39 in Bennett, Parker at 42 degrees. So not as cold as it has been the last few mornings, but certainly going to want that light jacket. Temperatures today reaching into the 70s at noon, near 80 degrees today. It's a warm one. Enjoy these temperatures while we have them because we've got changes coming. We'll talk about that in just a few.
And let's get to that time saver traffic alert. Sky Fox live over the scene right now. There is some good news here. We're talking about one lane of traffic now open up in the westbound direction of I-70. It was completely shut down just a moment ago. And we did just get an update from Colorado State Patrol. 4 cars involved in the crash. There were injuries as well. In fact, I saw someone being taken away in an ambulance. But again, now one lane of that westbound direction of I-270 is now open up. This crash right there near York. But you still see emergency crews on the scene right there. And look at the map here, guys. This is 270 in the westbound direction. The delays have spilled all the way into I-70 in that westbound direction. So 270, not a shortcut this morning. Just take I-70 to I-25, and that'll get you on the north side of town. But Kirk and Ashley will let you guys know when this crash completely clears. Now one lane open up.
All right, Drew, thank you.
Man from Denver facing kidnapping and sexual assault charges after investigators say he used his job as a Lyft driver to prey on intoxicated women.
Yeah, this is a crazy story. We are told that there may be at least 10 victims, possibly more. Let's get right to Fox 31's Jim Hooley on it live in Lodo with the details, Jim.
Ashley, good morning. This is where this guy like the work police say, working the bars and the clubs down here in the Lodo area, picking up women who thought they were going to be getting a safe ride home. And that was far from what turned out to be the case. He's been working out here since 2018 for the past 4 years. And so that's why police think there's certainly maybe more victims out there. Here's what's happening out here. Take a look at his picture here. This is the guy that police have under arrest this morning, the Lyft driver. His name is John Pastor Mendoza. He's 41 years old, and he's now facing 41 charges, including kidnapping and sexual assault. Denver police say he preyed on his victims here at the clubs, not only in Lodo, but in Rhino and the South Broadway area, too, assaulting women in his car or at an apartment.
For some of these women, there may be doubt as to what happened to them. For some that recognize what happened, there may be blaming. They blame themselves.
And now police say when Pastor Mendoza was arrested, he had a box containing up to 18 cell phones with him, some belonging to some of the victims who have already come forward, and some possibly belonging to victims who no one knows about yet. That's why police are so concerned. The Lyft company, by the way, says Pastor Mendoza has been permanently banned from working for them in the future. If you have any information, obviously police believe that there's more people out there, more victims out there. If you recognize that man, if you had any contact with them, police have a special number set up. That is 720-913-2000. Please contact the Denver police if you have any information right away. Live in Lowell this morning, I'm Jim Hooley, Fox 30.
Yeah, just an unsettling report there, Jim, and something that hopefully there aren't more victims out there, but if there are, police trying to connect the dots. Thanks.
An organized crime unit has made a major bust in Arapahoe County that left a trail of victims, including people whose identity was stolen. Convenience store clerks were some of the victims who came in direct contact with this crime ring. The district's attorney has named six stores that were robbed, including 7-Elevens and Circle K's. The district attorney saying several car dealerships were also targets. Investigators say the crime ring used fraudulent papers to buy cars, some of them high-end cars, that were then used in the crimes. The illegally purchased cars made it illegal to track down the suspects, but a break came in the case when one of the stolen cars was involved in an accident. Police reported finding firearms and stolen mail that belonged to multiple identity theft victims.
When we first started the case, these people had no idea that their identity had been stolen out of a vehicle. One was stolen out of a dumpster from a data breach from a company that they worked for.
Six people have been indicted on 54 counts. They were indicted for their alleged roles in running a sophisticated criminal enterprise involving identity theft, forgery, aggravated motor vehicle theft, aggravated robbery, and even attempted murder. The district attorney said part of the crime unit's goal is stop the catch and release of criminals.
A dangerous intersection in Aurora has neighbors turning to the Fox 31 problem solvers asking for help. Where Fourth Way meets Havana, there's different colored fences surrounding a home there that's not a design choice. In the last 2 years, cars have crashed into this home six times. So much so, they put cameras up to show the problem. Look at that. Wow. You see his dog in the yard there when a car comes crashing right into their fence. This crash from February, the car went into his sister's bedroom with her inside. The crashes continue, they say. More cars narrowly missing loved ones inside. Other neighbors showed us pictures of people with walkers crossing the road dangerously because there's no crosswalk there. Additional homes down the stretch also having cars crash into their fences as well.
Safety, definitely, it is a big issue. City of Aurora, CDOT have actually both of them keep us on limbo.
CDOT and Aurora tell the problem solvers they are, in fact, working together to address safety on this stretch of road. CDOT specifically saying they are anticipating to install a signal, a traffic light at the corner, but they have to wait for construction to wrap up across the street, so it'll probably be within the next couple of years, they say. Out of this world photos, literally.
This is so cool. NASA releasing new images from the James Webb Space Telescope. More new images. And Drew, you've been looking at these all morning long, and we've been saying, man, this is awesome.
Aren't those amazing?
Yeah.
That's my screen.
I don't even know what I'm looking at.
Is it?
Right.
That's going to be
amazing. I can actually hook you up with that.
Awesome.
I'll grab the picture for you, send it to you. Hey, the pillars of creation is what was first captured by the Hubble Space Telescope in 1995. It's about 6,500 light years from Earth. The image always deemed iconic by space observers out there. out there, and now we're getting a look that we have never seen before. You're looking at part of the Eagle Nebula. It's in the iconic stellar birthplace known as the Pillars of Creation. This jaw-dropping image was captured by the James Webb Space Telescope. It shows bright red, yellow, and blue stars shining within a massive billowing cloud of dust and gas. Now, we talked a lot about the James Webb Telescope recently. A lot of people have. It's all over the internet as well, because the $10 billion Space Observatory launched just last December. And Kirk and Ashley, we're told, guys, it has enough fuel to continue snapping these unprecedented images of space for about 20 years. So we are just on the brink right now. And you think just at the end of last year is when the telescope got up there. Yeah. We've got a ways to go when it comes to images like these. It'll be amazing to watch.
To continue to watch as they release more.
No doubt about it.
I don't know. Do they use filters on there, though? It feels like Instagram filters right now.
You asked me earlier if I did that. You think I could make something like that, Kirk? Come on.
Take a lot of time. Yeah.
If you're still having trouble booking a flight for a fall trip, one airline CEO says he knows why. The guy who runs United says hybrid work has caused a permanent structural change in leisure travel demand. Scott Kirby is his name. He told Fox Business that's why this September, which is typically an off-peak month, was the third strongest month in the history of that airline. He says it's not pent-up demand from COVID. That's over. It's the new normal after COVID. And speaking of airline travel, many of us can remember a time decades ago before September 11th when you could go to the gate at the airport without a ticket to pick up loved ones, to meet somebody who had just arrived. It was, you know, when I was a kid, that's how you did it.
Yeah, my parents walked me right up. Now you have to have special exceptions for those sort of things. And one airport, though, changing that, bringing it back, Ontario International Airport in Southern California launching a new program that allows non-ticketed travelers to fully enter the airport terminal after they're screened through TSA. So visitors can fill out an online application for a pass or do it at the airport.
UC Health has a new tool to help reach patients in far-off places for critical care. Look at this. This is their new fixed-wing aircraft. It's a plane. It's part of the Lifeline fleet, which also includes, of course, five helicopters. UC Health says those helicopters are great, but they can only respond to emergencies within 150 miles. This new plane can transport patients up to 900 miles, can fly in bad weather. This helps facilitate patient transfers from rural or very remote hospitals.
If you think rent in the Denver metro area is bad, a new study says people who earn minimum wage in New York need to work more than 100 hours per week just to afford a place to live. That's according to a survey by United Way. Based on New York's $15 an hour minimum wage, people have to work 111 hours per week on minimum wage. The average rent for a one-bedroom apartment is $4,000 a month.
So you finally afford this apartment in New York, but you don't actually spend any time there because you're
at
work.
You may as well live at work.
You're at work.
Sleep at work. 100 hours a week.
Oh, my gosh.
That's wild.
Yeah, that is wild. 20 minutes till 7 right now. You know what's wild is the fact that it's going to be nearly 80 today.
I know. Really, really warm day ahead, guys. We do have some changes coming this weekend, and I am watching for your first potential freeze, so we'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. But let's get you out the door this morning. Your bus stop forecast, get those kiddos out there. It's not going to be as cold as it has been. Low 40s for taking them out to the bus stop, and then for later on this afternoon in the upper 70s, mild, maybe a touch of a breeze at times. But what a beautiful morning from your Backers and Shanker camera. Temps right now in the mid to upper 40s. We've got just a little bit of a breeze, 44 degrees in Denver, 42 in Aurora, Parker at 38. Guys, today near 80 degrees. We stay this way for a few days. We'll talk about the changes coming this weekend in just a few.
Well, how much money would you be willing to pay for a burned up house? Look at this. This is for sale, and the listing is going viral. Wait until you hear the asking price.
It's bonkers. Plus, they've been without mail for days. The problem solvers get into the bottom of what's holding up deliveries for this neighborhood. And Drew is watching a time saver traffic alert. Big issue this morning.
Yeah, I-270. Do not even think about taking I-270 in the westbound direction this morning, guys. Still one lane of traffic open up. This four-car crash did involve injuries. The interstate was completely shut down in that westbound direction for a short time. But just take I-70 to I-25. I-270 westbound completely stacked. The entire length of 270 is blocked right now because of that crash there at York. But Sky Fox Live in the air. Of course, any issues out there on the roads or breaking news, we've got it first here on Fox 31. Stay with us.
You're watching Fox 31, Colorado's most watched morning news. From Denver, this is Fox 31 News.
Reset Now, 6:44 on your Thursday morning. It's that time of the year. We are partnering again with Dependable Cleaners for our annual Coats for Colorado campaign. So we need your help. Start going through your closets. Anything that is new or gently used, we would love if you could make a donation right now to any Dependable Cleaners location. We have a full list at KDVR.com.
6:45. It is Thursday morning. Hanging out here in the weather pod, the brand new weather pod. A nice new digs you got over here, Kylie.
Thank you. I like it a lot. Welcome to my new home. It's been nice to actually, you know, be able to show off the weather in a way that's really impactful for Colorado, because we've got some big changes on the way. Quiet today, but we are going to see some big changes by this weekend. Here's a look at what I'm watching for you. We've got more warm days on the way, weekend showers, including rain and even snow. I'll show you what I mean in a second here. But first, gorgeous morning from your Backus and Shanker camera. Absolutely beautiful. Sun officially up in about 30 minutes from now, mid to upper 40s. Just a touch of a breeze so far this morning. We're at 30 degrees in Greeley, 20s and 30s through your high country. And we're looking at radar right now. Things are quiet. We don't have a lot going on hour by hour. Today, we're going to be in the 70s by noon and near 80 for later on today. In fact, several spots reaching into the low 80s. 82 in Fort Collins and Greeley, 78 in Lyman, 60s and 70s through your high country. As far as your wind goes, fairly light, 5 to 10 miles per hour today. All right, let's talk about the weekend, though, because it's quiet the next few days. A lot of people talking about that first big mountain snowfall for the season, and it's looking like it's likely going to be this weekend. As we get into Sunday morning, keep in mind, it's Thursday. We're talking about Sunday. Things could change. We'll be watching it for you. And we've got some pretty impactful mountain snow. I think the most likely scenario is that we're going to see some light rain here in the metro area. Maybe a couple of snowflakes in the metro, but I don't think it'll be our first snow. We'll watch it for you, though. We'll keep an eye on it. But pretty impactful, 3 to 6, maybe even up toward 10 inches in our mountains, which is really lovely to see. I know a lot of ski resorts are making snow. Great to add some of the real stuff to it. All right, 7-day forecast. We're in the 70s through the next several days. Sunday down into the 60s. It's going to be windy. Monday in the low 50s. And then heads up, guys, early next week, I know we're all talking about the mountain snow. I think one of the bigger impacts for the Front Range will be our first potential freeze in the Denver metro area.
80 degrees, almost 80 degrees almost today. And then we're talking freeze in 5 days from now.
You got to love Colorado.
I do love Colorado. Thank you, Kylie. Jumping into breaking news at 6:47. This is huge. After only 6 weeks in office, British Prime Minister Liz Truss says she's quitting.
Well, this makes her the shortest serving prime minister of Britain ever. And they have gone through so much of, you know, votes of no confidence for previous prime ministers. Boris Johnson left in what was definitely some controversial moments there in Britain as well. And now Liz Truss, after just 6 weeks, is out.
Yeah, she answers to the Queen to some extent. She had to tender her resignation to the King, excuse me, not no longer the Queen, to the King. But at the same time, you know, for all intents and purposes, it's essentially the President of Britain. It's the Prime Minister. And so this is a big deal. And we're told within the next week there will be a new leadership election there. So a lot to watch. Breaking news out of the UK on this Thursday morning. Liz Truss quitting, stepping down as prime minister. How much of your income, how much of your paycheck goes just towards paying bills before you get to do anything else with that money?
Well, we have new data this morning for people living in Denver. Let's get right to Fox 31's Lisa D'Souza on it live this morning. Lisa.
Well, the latest numbers are not too exciting as we head closer to the weekend. They show a whopping 42% of household incomes in our city. They all go to our bills. So picture more than $2,000 a month all going to your living expenses. So this is coming from a new report from bill payment company Doxo. It ranked the 50 largest U.S. cities based on average monthly bills that were reported to the government. Well, Denver is the 13th most expensive of those big cities. So here's a closer look at the numbers. The average total for bills, about $2,273 here in Denver. The national average, for perspective, just over $2,000. So most money, of course, going to rent or mortgage payments. From there, it's car payments, more than $400 on average. Utilities, about $300, car insurance, nearly $200. So the most expensive city for monthly bills, in case you're wondering, it's San Jose, California, more than $3,000. We've got a full breakdown of this study up on our website. Just click on a link to this story, but not the ideal thing you want to hear, because what do you have money left over for at that point? 42%, that's huge.
Yeah, that's.
Well, and
you're out.
I would love if those were my numbers.
Yeah.
But, I mean, if you've got a family of, especially for Kirk, a family of five, that's just not even.
Well, that's why I live in Castle Rock.
That's true.
That's why I live 30 minutes away from this city.
But even then, it's like everything is just so much more expensive.
Thanks, Lisa.
Residents in a Lakewood neighborhood waiting for bills, election information, and other mail now for several days. The problem solvers looked into it and found some metro area delays are due to the national workforce shortage.
I am looking forward to my ballot, and I hadn't seen that yet.
We appreciate the work that they are doing, but it'd be great to kind of get back on that daily schedule.
The USPS tells Fox 31 when issues occur due to staffing or weather and we are not able to make a delivery, that mail is prioritized for the following day. It's a very rare circumstance for a customer to go without mail for more than 48 hours. The problem solvers talked to other residents in that same block, and they say they've actually received their mail on time. The USPS says mail to that area is now restored. Currently, the greater Denver area has a need for more than 120 carriers. So if you would like to apply for a job, we do have a lot of information at KDVR.com. Just click on the story.
New this morning, one gas station chain plans to break into the marijuana business. Circle K stores in Florida will start selling cannabis next year. The company says they hope it'll make the drug more mainstream, but customers will need special cards to buy since Florida still only allows medical marijuana sales. A problem solver's health alert, Connor Joe, you may know him as a left fielder for the Colorado Rockies, but maybe you didn't know he's actually a survivor of testicular cancer, diagnosed at just 27 years old when playing for the Dodgers.
So without that organization kind of mandating these physicals, would you have gotten this physical on your own?
No, definitely not. And that's what makes it so scary is I had no symptoms and like most men, pretty reluctant to go into doctors.
Joe has been cancer-free for 2 years. His message to men ages 18 to 35, go get checked or screen yourself. The Testicular Cancer Society says only 4 in 10 American men check themselves for the disease. Some bad news for the Colorado Avalanche. The team announcing Gabe Landeskog had surgery on his knee this week. The team says Landy, the captain, will miss 12 weeks, give or take. Oh, man, 3 months without Landeskog is not what we want to hear. Captain, oh, captain. So hopefully he'll get healthy and get back as soon as possible. A property in Golden, it's going viral, attracting quite a lot of attention. The house was destroyed by a fire and is now being listed, despite all the damage, for $840,000.
This is crazy. Look at this. This house and lot sit on West 17th Place in Golden. One person was killed in this fire that happened in mid-January. Since then, the house has already been sold once. Real estate agent Jenna McMenamin, who is not the listing agent, says the market has been cooled off for a bit now from the past few years at least, but does remain at a record pace.
A lot of times what we're doing right now is we're pricing based on comps that went under contract a month ago and closing recently. And so our comps aren't moving quite as quickly as they were last year. But that's not allowing the market to catch up in the meantime.
Edmund says selling in the fall is still a great option because there is more negotiating and people are more motivated. A rescue dog now back home after getting lost for more than a month. Suki went missing right after she was put on a flight to Newark. But shortly after the plane landed, she escaped. A professional pet tracker put out a cage and multiple cameras, plenty of treats to try and lure her out of hiding. After a lot of long nights, she was found near train tracks in an industrial area near the airport.
It's an all-night endeavor, so if she doesn't show, what I wind up doing is you tie it open with a bungee cord and you turn it into a crate with food. And that's exactly what she did this time.
And she's doing all right. She's just, you know, a little skinny, a little skin and bones right now, but that's nothing we can't fix.
And there's a fitting end to this story, too. Suki will soon have a new owner, a woman who ended up losing her dog but never found him.
We're coming straight back with your Fox 31 Morning Rush. All the news you need to know to get this Thursday started.
Including no eviction without representation. With a lot of people struggling to afford housing right now, we're taking a closer look at ballot initiative 305 that's up to Denver voters in a few weeks. Time now, 6:57, and time for the Fox 31 Morning Rush. A quick look at the top stories this morning before you head out.
Big breaking news, international breaking news. British Prime Minister Liz Truss quitting after her policies triggered economic turmoil and obliterated her authority. Truss said she tendered her resignation to the king and a leadership election will take place within a week. That timeline will easily make her, by a long shot, the shortest serving British prime minister ever, just 6 weeks on the job.
Gorgeous morning where your back is in tanker camera. Temps right now, they're pretty mild for this time of year. We've got a warm day ahead. We'll talk about some changes coming though in just a few.
And a time saver traffic alert that we've been tracking since about 5:30 this morning, guys. The westbound direction of I-270. The good news is the two cars remaining in this crash, four cars in total, are now on the tow truck. Should be out of the way soon, but still down to one lane of traffic. I-270 completely backed up to take I-70 to I-25.
This morning, a Denver Lyft driver is under arrest. He's charged with sexually assaulting and kidnapping at least 10 women over the last 4 years here on the streets of Denver. His name is John Pastor Mendoza. He's facing more than 41 charges, and police think that there may be more victims out there. If you have any information whatsoever, please contact Denver Police Investigators at 720-913-2000.
A top U.S. military general pays a visit to a ballistic missile submarine somewhere in the Arabian Sea. He spent about 8 hours aboard the USS West Virginia when the submarine surfaced in an undisclosed location. It's a long-range sub and can launch nuclear missile strikes. Its location typically kept under wraps for security reasons.
President Biden heading to Pennsylvania today, where he will weigh in on one of the most closely watched races in the midterm elections. Pennsylvania Senate candidate Mehmet Oz, hoping to build enthusiasm in the final weeks of his campaign, a race that could very well determine the balance of power in the Senate. Right now, it's neck and neck between Oz and Pennsylvania's Democratic Lieutenant Governor John Fetterman.
We're just getting started here on Fox, as we got a lot more coming up for you. We stay live and local all morning long while the other networks in town flip that switch to pre-taped news out of New York City. We're here till noon.
Fox 31 Morning News at 7 starts right now.
You're watching continuing local news coverage from Colorado's biggest news team. Now, Fox 31 Morning News at 7.
All aboard, RTD making commutes a little easier when you can start bringing your e-bike along with you.
Plus, a problem solver's health alert and a new warning for women who vape.
And did you know pumpkin spice foods actually cost a whole lot more than the regular version? How much more you're paying just to get some of that PSL? Good to have you. It is Thursday morning. Obviously, we're hanging out in our brand new studio. Finally, after months in the newsroom, we're happy to be able to show it off to you. I'm Kirk Yonke.
I'm Ashley Ryan. I think everyone's happy we're in here, too. Our producer's getting sick of us. Let's get over to Kylie at 7 o'clock on your Thursday morning with your beautiful new weather wall, Kylie.
I know. I really am loving this. We can show off Colorado's beautiful sunrises. I